नेक्स्ट आरएनए
इज नथिंग बट राइबो न्यूक्लिक एसिड.
आरएनए इज सिंगल स्टैंडर्ड.
आरएनए इज सिंगल स्ट्रैंड.
नेक्स्ट बेस पेयर रूल एंड चारगाफ रूल्स आर नॉट अप्लीकेबल.
बेस पेयर रूल कमा चारगाफ रूल आर नॉट अप्लीकेबल.
Because of it is not double strand RNA, only single strand RNA we are talking about. So Chargaff rule, base pair rules are not applicable. RNA is mainly made up of pentose sugar, nitrogen bases plus phosphoric acid. It is also polynucleotide chain, comma. It is also pentose sugar, nothing but here pentose sugar is different. Ribose sugar. In case of DNA, deoxyribose sugar. Here RNA, that's why it is a ribose sugar. Nitrogen bases are mainly purines and pyrimidines. Purines are adenine, comma, guanine. Next to nitrogen pyrimidines are cytosine and uracil. Thymine is absent. So adenine and guanine are the purines. Cytosine comma uracil are the pyrimidines. Means here in case of DNA, U is replaced by T. Thymine is present, but this is RNA. T is absent. T is replaced by uracil. Next, phosphoric acid as well as phosphoric acid. So it is also polynucleotide chain. In case of we are taking structure, this is the pentose sugar, nothing but that is ribose sugar, not deoxyribose, ribose sugar. First, nitrogen base is attached here, and here two functional groups are present, hydrogen and hydroxyl. Here third carbon also hydrogen comma hydroxyl, fourth one hydrogen, and CH2OH is freely attaches it to fifth carbon. First carbon nitrogen, second carbon hydrogen group and as well as hydroxyl group, third carbon also hydrogen group and hydroxyl group, and fourth carbon only hydrogen group, and fifth carbon CH2OH is freely attaches at top. Single oxygen molecules, we know that. So here two functional groups are present means it is more reactive, not stable. That's why it have two functional groups. That's why it is more reactive is one thing, and not stable, because two functional groups is there. Next nucleotide, it is as attaches with here these two hydroxyl groups. Because two functional groups are present, these two functional groups helps in to bind with to another nucleotide will be attaches with the second and third carbons, because of second and third carbons are the functional groups. Two functional groups are present, second comma third carbons, second and third carbons are functional groups. And phosphate is attached here. So this is phosphate attached here. Phosphate is attached here. This is phosphate. Next, phosphate attaches with the fifth carbon. At the fifth carbon, CH2OH is freely attached. That's why H and this OH are binded, releases water. By the bond is formed. That is phospho, that is diester bond. That bond is formed. Phospho diester bond is formed by phosphoric acid and pentose sugar. Phosphoric acid, comma pentose sugar, both are attaches at fifth carbon, and H of phosphoric acid and OH of pentose sugar, both are joined together to formation of a phospho diester bond and releases one molecule of water will be released, that is phospho diester bond. And here nitrogen base is attaches with first carbon, that is glycosidic bond. Here this bond, glycosidic bond will be formed, glycosidic bond, and as well as that is phospho diester bond. This is glycosidic bond formed between first carbon of pentose sugar and nitrogen base, and fifth carbon of OH binds with H of phosphoric acid to releases water molecule to formation of a bond, that is phospho diester bond. Next, types of RNA. Which is first RNA, comma types. First type mRNA. It is also called as messenger RNA. It means DNA transmit as mRNA. mRNA changes into protein. Here mRNA is replicate to formation of mRNA by the process of transcription, and mRNA translate it DNA genetical information to formation of a protein, that is translation. Once DNA is divided or replicate to formation of mRNA. So mRNA is a copy of DNA. By the process of transcription, DNA to form mRNA. So DNA replicate to formation of mRNA by the process of transcription. So mRNA receive the information from DNA, that is genetical information. mRNA receive genetical information from the DNA, that information translate as a protein. That information used to make up protein by the process of translation. So mRNA helps in transport or translate the information of genetical information to protein. That's why it is a messenger RNA. That's why it is a messenger RNA. Next, rRNA. rRNA is ribosomal RNA, which is also helps in protein synthesis. So helps in protein synthesis. Next, third type of RNA is tRNA, which is transfer the amino acids from the cytoplasm to site of protein synthesis. So which are helps in transport the amino acids from cytoplasm to site of protein synthesis. So this tRNA or transfer RNA which is helps in transport the amino acids from cytoplasm to where the proteins are synthesized, because amino acids are joined together to formation of a protein. That's why this tRNA helps to transport that amino acids and sends to the site of that is a protein synthesis. That's why it is a transfer RNA. Transport the amino acids from the cytoplasm to where the protein synthesis, that is site of protein synthesis, that is tRNA. mRNA just send the message from the DNA to protein. Next, rRNA, which is ribosomal RNA, helps in protein synthesis, and tRNA helps in transport the amino acids from the cytoplasm to that is site of protein synthesis. This is about two three types, and individually we have to take in detailed information in next class. In next class we are talking about mRNA. We are starting with the mRNA in next class.